So I think if you've been following me, you know that I've been complaining that whenever I come to Europe, all the paintings are of John the Baptist. But in reality, I've, you know, stopped complaining because what it shows you is where the money is, where the money used to be. It also shows you a couple of other things, which is primarily that whoever has the money is able to influence the culture. And that doesn't mean the culture that they are depicting is actually a good culture or a dominant culture. It just happens to be who has access to the purse, whether public or private. And again, if you've seen all these things, it becomes really dull to the extent that that you're not able to click on something that tells you what this person was famous for. That, of course, leads me to the other lesson, which is that if you want to try to become immortal, this was their way of doing it. Building buildings, paintings, and of course, we don't recognize any of these people. This person is obviously famous enough to have a portrait commissioned, but I guarantee you don't know who he is. And so if you're in a position where you think that, you know, there's always been this battle between people who want to become immortal, and also, of course, people that recognize it's probably not worth it, simply because if all you have left is a...
Yeah.